Let's now try to understand what is ASCII. ASCII stands for American Standard Code for Information Interchange. If you take a look at your keyboard, whether it's the mobile keyboard or your computer or laptop keyboard, there are a number of characters like A, B, C, question mark, and so on. So these characters are represented by symbols on your keyboard. So characters are nothing but symbols used for representation and for helping the user communicate with the computer. Now, if you look at what characters are used, they vary from programming language to programming language. Not every programming language is going to use the same character set. If you take a look at my character set lecture earlier, I have shown you what are the legal characters that are going to be used or that are permitted to be used in a C program. If you look at COBOL, if you look at Fortran, if you look at Java, they may not have the same character set which is permitted by C. So the characters which are permitted in each language are unique to that programming language. Now, if you look at the character on the keyboard, for me and you it is 1, 2, 3, A, question mark, equal to, plus, minus, flower bracket, round bracket, and so on. But internally, every character is represented in terms of zeros and ones. That means it is represented in binary numbers. Now, there are various ways of representing these characters. For example, in one system, let us say the number A may be represented by decimal number 65. In another system, the number capital A may be represented by decimal number 100. So the same character can be represented internally using different formats. Now, what I am trying to tell you here is each of the character is mapped to a number. For example, the decimal value of capital A in the ASCII format is going to be 65, capital A. Capital B is 66, and so on all the way till capital Z is 90. Small a starts at 97 in decimal and ends at 122 decimal for small z. The digits 0 starts at 48 and ends at 57 for the number 9. Now, as each character is represented to a number, there are different schemes which are used to map a character to a number. So one such scheme is called as EBCDIC, which stands for Extended Binary Coded Decimal Interchange Code. We're not really bothered about that because we're not going to very frequently, or in fact probably I myself have never used that in my life. But we are going to talk about ASCII. ASCII stands for American Standard Code for Information Interchange. That means it is used to represent characters internally using certain combination of ones and zeros, which when you convert to decimals will have a fixed value. For example, I had already told you the uppercase characters starting from A are internally represented in decimal 65 and capital Z is represented till decimal 90. But A is not represented as 65 in decimal. 65 is converted to ones and zeros, and whatever is the value of 65 in binary, that is the representation used to represent A. Capital A. Capital B is 66. Capital C is 67. Capital D is 68, and so on. Then lowercase is represented from 97 to 122 in decimal. 97 is again converted to binary and represented in binary. Z is converted from 122 in decimal to binary, and the binary representation is used. I have given you decimal numbers so that we really understand their values. If I show you in terms of ones and zeros, it is impossible for us to understand whether it is 65, 90, and so on. Digits are represented starting from 48 to 57. So character 0 is 48, character 9 is 57. Now suppose I have a character, let's say I have a combination A and B, which is to be stored in one memory after the other. We all know that a single character occupies one byte. So this A will occupy one byte, B will occupy one byte. So A will be stored as 65 and B will be stored as 66. Just to remind you, this 65 is going to be converted into binary. This 66 is going to be converted into binary, and they are going to be stored in one memory location after the other. Now, in order to understand the concept of ASCII a little better, let's try to take a look at a small piece of code. So what I have done here is, I have written a small C program to print the ASCII value or internal representation of the character A. So I have defined a variable called as C of the type character, and I have given it the initial value A. Now when I print it as percentage C, it is going to print as A. But if I try to print this same C as percentage D, it is going to print it as 65, because internally this A is represented with the value 65. So this should have given you an idea that every character on the keyboard is internally represented in terms of ones and zeros. Okay, it is not the character A or character B which is stored. Everything in the computer memory, whether it's on the hard disk or on the main memory or on the ROM, is in terms of ones and zeros. Different characters are given different binary values. Okay, and that's why it's called as mapping of each character to a number. So we have different schemes to represent characters. One is the EBC, DIC, and the other is the ASCII. We are going to use the ASCII scheme extensively. Now, I have told you about character A to Z, lowercase a to Z, and so on. But then there are other ASCII characters also. This is too many ASCII characters, so there's no way I can show it to you big enough. But what will happen is, in the description of this particular video, you can have access to this particular table. You can take a look at this table and you will find the character and the corresponding ASCII value. For example, if you want to take a look at it, 47 in decimal, okay, stands for the semicolon symbol. Similarly, 40 in decimal stands for the flower bracket, the left flower bracket. 41 stands for the right flower bracket. 42 stands for the star symbol. 43 stands for plus. Okay, 44 stands for the hash. 45 stands for the minus. So this way, all of the characters are internally stored using these particular numbers. So here in the first column, you have the decimal representation. Then here you have the binary representation. So this is the representation used to store internally. And finally, we have also shown as the octal and also the hexadecimal representation. So this is the hexadecimal representation of the number. This is the octal, and this is the binary representation of semicolon or whatever it is. I want you to take a look at this particular table. Look at the description. Look at what is the ASCII value of each character. In most of programming, you need to know only the ASCII values of capital A to capital Z, small a to small z, and you need to know the digits start from 0 to 57. That's all. Other than that, you really do not need to worry about the ASCII value of different characters. No need to mug it up. You just have to go look at the table and figure out what are the ASCII values. So if you look at this chart, the ASCII value of character A is 65. So if I come here, you can see here, this is 65, and here very small you can see A. So A is represented as 1, so many zeros and ending with 1. In octal it is represented as 101. So this is the way characters are represented internally in a computer.